Welcome to Tangata Pasifika, ma aloe lele.
Kia ora ana, tāna whakoutou. On the show today, we're live at Polyfest 2015 with reporter Alistair Cutter.
Kia ora ana, marama and Tom. Yes, that's right, I am down here at the Polyfest in Monaco. As you can see behind me, the Samoan stage is heating up. Later on, I'll be speaking to some of the people who make this event such a huge success 40 years on. Back to you guys.
Thank you, Alistair. Also on the show today, controversial issue of male circumcision, to cut or not to cut.
If you're not going to benefit from it in today's era, I don't really see the evidence that it makes any difference to the outcomes of whether you're being circumcised or not.
And we meet a Tongan netballer rising up the national ranks.
I love a new challenge and, like, you know, coming up against Irene and stuff.
Welcome to the show. It's great to have your company. We'd love to hear your thoughts on any of our stories today. Drop us a line on Facebook or Twitter.
But first, we have Pasifik News with Susanna Gurumbil.
Thanks, guys. Vanuatu's Consul General is vowing his people will get back on their feet after Cyclone Pam ripped through the country last week. Aid from across the Pacific's been flowing in to help the disaster-stricken nation cope with Pam's destruction as a state of emergency remains in place. Despite hundreds still without food and power, Vanuatu Consul General Mackenzie Kalotiti says the country will survive.
Every Pacific Islanders are alike, you know, we're resilient. We had nothing before the cyclone came, Majori, and we'll still smile. And they know, like our motto says, in God we stand. That's the basic root of a Vanuatu society. It's about the spirit of giving, spirit of loving, the spirit of unity. And they'll get back on their feet.
Kalotiti says it's the worst cyclone he's seen. The death toll is now at 11. And Vanuatu isn't the only Pacific nation left struggling following Cyclone Pam's path of destruction. Tuvalu was also affected, with many residents left without food, power or shelter. Tuvalu's Prime Minister Enele Sopoanga says nearly half the country's population of 10,000 have been displaced. Auckland Tuvalu and Community Secretary Sanga Malua says Tuvalu also needs assistance.
The whole of Tuvalu Nation, all the people were affected by Cyclone Pam, and it's sad that not many people know about it, but we are looking for some funding, some assistance from the people of New Zealand.
And if you want to help donate to the Cyclone Pam victims, check out our Facebook page for more info. Auckland Mayor Len Brown is adamant he still has the support of the Pacific community, despite key campaign staff and mayoral advisers privately endorsing another candidate ahead of next year's local body elections. The Herald reported this week that Brown's lost support from his closest advisers, some of whom have met with former Labor leader Phil Goff to discuss the possibility of running. Brown wouldn't comment on his loss of support, but says he's confident the Pacific community will still back him.
Oh, look, I don't have to speak to them. They speak to me all the time, and they're very strong in their reflection back to me that they support me as their mayor and will continue to do so.
And Goff says he's still deciding whether he will run for the Auckland mayoralty. And still with Len Brown, he was on hand to recognise the efforts of a group who have helped around 60,000 school children learn to swim thanks to a free program aimed at low decile schools. Auckland Sport and Recreation's offered more than 500,000 swimming lessons over the past 4 years to help lower New Zealand's drowning rate. The lessons are aimed at low decile schools, which have a high number of Māori and Pacific students. Aquatic Action Plan Project Manager Andrew Tara says Pacific people need to learn to survive in the water.
We go to the beach during the summer and we like to take the whole family, pack up the whole house and get to the beach. But what we want is we want those families to have a good time. And if they do get into trouble, we want them to be able to survive.
The free swimming lessons will continue next year. And finally this week, Government Broadcasting Funding Agency New Zealand On Air celebrated 25 years of providing Kiwi content. The celebrations were held at Parliament and recognised producers for their contributions in helping to provide local content across various platforms. Among the recipients were the Coco Net producer Lisa Taouma and musician Moana Maniapoto for her music video Ae I O O. And that's our Pacific News. Back to you, Tom and Marama.
Thank you, Susana. Awelahi.